name is Mark Herrmann. I'm a plasma physicist, and I currently am the director of the National Ignition Facility, which is the world's largest, most energetic laser at the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in Livermore, California. Inertial confinement fusion is really, all it's saying is, for any given plasma I put together, there's a finite amount of time it takes for it to fall apart. And if I can get more fusions to take place before it falls apart, then I can actually get more energy out than I invested into it, and I can create fusion ignition and get a burning plasma, which is something that is useful for many applications. In order for something to fuse, it needs to be very hot. The fusion reactor we're most familiar with is the sun. On NIF, which is the acronym for the National Ignition Facility, we use 192 individual laser beams. We point those lasers at a gold can, and at the inside of it, we have a thin layer of deuterium and tritium fusion fuel. As the lasers heat up the inside of this gold can, it starts to become an oven. The outside layers rocket off away from that capsule because they're very hot. In reaction, the rest of the capsule moves in. That kinetic energy is rapidly turned into pressure. That pressure heats up the fusion fuel, and we start to get fusion reactions taking place. And the idea of fusion ignition is the alpha particles are driving a runaway reaction, in essence. You can think of it as lighting the end of a matchstick. So that's what ignition would be like, only it's in spherical in all directions. The standard that was set by the National Academy of Sciences when NIF was first proposed in the late 1990s was define fusion ignition as the fusion energy out equals the amount of laser energy we deposit into the target. We've actually increased the fusion yield output from the facility in an experiment by about a factor of two, so that's exciting. But we still have a long way to go. What we need in science is people who are innovative, and we need people who are also willing to challenge the status quo. And we can put a new experiment inside the facility every day and do something different. We have an opportunity to innovate in fusion, and so that's why I think it would be good. I would recommend people to go into that field.